We mentioned, we know it's kind of balanced, men and women, but I wanted to go back to the men because apparently there's a lot of impacts from diabetes that I understand where there could be fatigue.
Yes.
For an individual, specifically a male, and even situations, other side effects like sexual health, it can be impacted. Is that correct, doctor?
That is correct.
Can you talk about that?
Absolutely. There are several ways in which diabetes can affect men in that sense, okay? Number one, there is an increased incidence of something called obstructive sleep apnea in diabetes, in diabetic men, which can lead to fatigue, okay? There is an increased incidence of low testosterone levels in men with diabetes, and there is an increased incidence of erectile dysfunction, which doesn't necessarily have to relate to testosterone levels. It can be also related to just the complication of neuropathy and decreasing blood flow. Which can be combined to lead to erectile dysfunction.
And can you explain that neuropathy for our viewers, maybe who maybe not?
Sure. So one of the complications of microangiopathies that can happen in patients with diabetes long term with out of control diabetes is that the nerve endings can be somehow damaged or malfunctioning. And there are multiple ways of manifesting this neuropathy. There is somatic neuropathy that can be manifested by tingling and numbing sensation and some sort of lack of feeling sensation in the extremities. But there is also autonomic neuropathy, which can be manifested in many ways, like tachycardia, orthostatic hypotension, which means lack of balance in terms of the blood pressure, but then also erectile dysfunction.